morning. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your morning flash update for this Tuesday, and this is the 4th of February, 2020, time about 9:10 a.m. Central Time. Well, the stock market likes what it's seeing, and that's probably because it's watching what China has done, putting limits on short selling again, telling mutual funds there they cannot sell out of shares unless it's a redemption. Those type of actions, adding, what, $172 billion to the reserve system, helps. It still doesn't solve the coronavirus. So you get your nice bounce in the market. The question is, can it hold? And as I'm looking at the market, the dollar is still strong, euro a little bit weaker. Most of the currencies just back and forth here. In the grain markets, it's a mixed bag right now. They're getting a bounce like so many markets did off the stock market today, but that bounce is starting to fade. Take a look at the energies. You got up to 51.70 in the WTI crude. You're now getting back to close to unchanged on the day. Same in the Brent. Nat gas, well, you probably need more weather here. China's LNG suppliers are already saying they're declaring force majeure. They can't get the product in or moved around the country because of all the quarantine controls. Where it's interesting today is that the cocoa, the coffee, and the cotton markets are acting better. So the soft commodities getting a bid. We're starting to see the safe haven money coming out of the bonds. Now, whether it comes back in, we'll have to wait and see. Tuesdays are rough. You get those funny days in them where they try to reverse as the markets go on, especially if you had a big Monday. In terms of the financial data, well, remember, it's backwards data, but it's still good. This is still December. We're in February already, but if you take a look, factory orders up in the headline will be 1.8%. They expected 1.3. Those are good numbers. New York ISM came in, and this is January, so this is a more recent number, 45.8 versus 39.1. That's a good number. Redbook weekly sales. These are very current numbers. And as you can see, they were up for the first 4 weeks of January. So the consumer is still out there in America. He's buying away. We saw a little bit of a slip on the from the previous week that it wasn't up as much when you look at the data a little differently the way the ICSC does. And the Reserve Bank of Australia, well, you know, they have a record low interest rate of 0.75. So some people were wondering, what was the bank going to do, come into the coronavirus situation? Would they sit tight? Tourism is hurt there. Obviously, they're a major supplier of raw goods to China. That's being impacted. At the other point, the banks come off a series of interest rate cuts that have supported housing, jobs, and so on. So the bank probably very properly said, let's sit and see how things play out for another little bit. They can always make an emergency move if they have to. But remember, they can only cut so much before they're in negative territory. So probably a good move to that side. It's going to be a wild trade day, I can tell you that right now. I'm going to be on Bloomberg in a few minutes, but if you're interested in our information, this is the kind of market you probably want to see it because it's all over the board. Our research throughout the day, and I'm not talking we write one report. You know, I look at so many different research firms or brokerage firms, and you don't get a lot of data throughout the day. Data is important. So we make this available through our platforms, through emails to you, and we write on a whole host of markets. And our people, be it the energy markets, and I'll be on today, I know I'll be talking about that on TV. What are the other markets, the technical, the financials, what are they all doing? Where's the market headed? If you'd like to see what we send to our clients, we'd like to give you a two-week free trial. How do you get it? Just call our staff, 866-973-2077, or you can go to our website and you'll see free offers. Sign up for it there. We'll put it in your hands. If you're watching us on YouTube, click right here, that icon. It'll take you right to that page. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day. Talk to you later today.